What time is it? It's food hack time. Okay, you guys, look what time it is. We are back for another Food Hack Friday. Now, when I looked over what we've done before, we've done a snack hack. We have done a breakfast hack. We've done a meal hack. And now it's time for a new hack. And this one involves bacon. Okay, you guys, so here is this month's food hack. And this time we are focusing on our side dishes. So we are going to make a bacon baked potato. Do you see that? Do you see how absolutely delicious that looks? Yes. Yes, if you watch any of my meal planning, you know that I generally incorporate just a little bit of bacon into our meal plan at least once a week, whether we divide it up and use it in a couple of recipes, but we are huge bacon lovers in this house. I know it's not the healthiest thing, but you guys, everything in this world is better with bacon. So when I saw this, I was like, okay, this is perfect. I was supposed to make stroganoff tonight, and I decided to change it up a little bit, and I made Swedish meatballs, and on the side, we're having these baked potatoes. So basically, they tell you to poke some holes in here and to stick this in the microwave, the potatoes, for 5 minutes. They just want you to soften them just a little bit to make them easier to cut slits into. Once they cool, they want you to cut 3 good slits in the potatoes, but not all the way through. And in between, you're supposed to place a slice of bacon. So this recipe does it in a breakdown of 2. So it says you would need 6 slices of bacon. I have a pound here. I probably won't use all of it. I don't think a full slice is necessary for each piece, but I'm gonna do 4 potatoes because we're a bigger family, so 2 potatoes is not going to cut it. So I'm gonna do 4 potatoes. But I decided to just elevate it just a little bit on my own. Why wouldn't I? Because the kitchen is my happy place, so I love to play with recipes. So bacon sounds delicious in here, but what potato has bacon without cheese? So I had a little bit of these Velveeta wedges that I had left over from a recipe that I made last month, and I don't use this that often, but I thought this would be great to roll in the bacon and then shove that in here, because I feel like cheesy bacon makes more sense than just the bacon and potato, doesn't it? I mean, cheese makes everything better, and so does bacon, so it sounds like a perfect combination to me. And then we're gonna grease this down with some olive oil and sprinkle a little bit of salt. Not a whole lot, because bacon and cheese are salty, so you don't want it to be too salty, but you just want to be able to give the skin a good flavor. And then we're going to stick them in a 350 degree oven for about 50 to 60 minutes. It does take a long time. Potatoes take a long time to cook in the oven, but otherwise they sound super delicious and not very complicated. So I'm going to get these guys into the microwave and let's get started. Okay, you guys, so we got our spuds here, and they have been washed and scrubbed down and set on the towel to dry. And now I'm just taking a fork and poking a couple of holes on each side of the potato so that it cooks well in the microwave. I did do a little bit longer than the 5 minutes, since it was for 2 potatoes, the 5 minutes, and this was for 4 potatoes. I did 8 minutes. Here is the bacon and cheese. I just kind of separated everything into the piles for each potato. 3 slices of cheese, and then I did take the long strips of bacon and cut them in half. So that is only 6 slices of bacon. Once the potatoes were cooled and able for me to handle them, I cut 3 good deep slits. Of course, not all the way in, but deep enough to be able to put the cheese and bacon inside of it. Then I just took 1 wedge of the Velveeta cheese, which ended up being perfect because Velveeta gets a little soft.
So I was basically able to mold it and get a really tight roll on it and be able to shove it really good down and deep into the potato. I knew the cheese was going to ooze out just a little bit, which it did, but it did stay for the most part inside of the potato while it was baking. Look at that, you guys. So stinking delicious. You have no idea how good these potatoes turned out. So once I was finished with that one, I just continued rolling the bacon and the cheese until I completed all of them. Once I was done rolling the cheese and bacon, I got my olive oil out and a basting brush, and I made sure to baste the potatoes really good. I did not baste the bottoms because I knew the grease was going to drip through, so I just gave a nice oil to the top of them and then sprinkled with my pink sea salt and placed them in the oven for exactly 60 minutes was the perfect time at 350 degrees.
Those look dynamite.
Okay guys, so here it is all plated up. I chose to put some sour cream on mine and I cut a little bit of green onion and sprinkled some pepper on top. But I have to say, this is probably the best baked potato I've ever had in my whole life. I ate two of them and ended up not eating any of the meatballs that I made for dinner because this was so good. So make sure you comment down below and let me know if this is something you want to try or if you try it, because this was honestly the best baked potato I have ever had. Make sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you love my Food Hack Fridays, which I do once a month here on the channel. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button. And for everybody else, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.